Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen wa salatu wa salam wa rasul al-mursaleen. My brothers and sisters in Islam, today khutbah we are going to talk about inshallah what we need, keeping the heart and the tongue clean. It's very important, my brothers, because everything's in our life depend on the heart and the tongue. In alhamdulillah nahmadu wa nasta'inu wa nastaghfiru wa nastahdi ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا محمد عبده ورسوله قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن الكريم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون As I said before, of course, قال الله سبحانه وتعالى يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء اتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا قال الله تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد my brothers and sisters in Islam the most important part of the body is the heart Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to us advised us indeed there is a piece of flesh in the body that if it's sound if it's good the whole body is going to be sound And if it's cropped, the whole body would be cropped. From Sahih al-Bukhari. Brother, then, Prince Sayyid Ahmad al-Kiram, then the heart is the place for where all action stems. All action comes from. Kull al-a'mal bin niyyah. Niyyah coming from the heart. Good and bad. The heart is a place that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala examine us. As the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah does not look at your bodies or look at your face, but you look, you examine your heart's action. From Sahih Muslim. لا يأخذكم, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لا يأخذكم الله باللغو في أيمانكم. ولكن يؤاخذكم بما كسبت قلوبكم والله غفور حليم meaning Allah will not take you to task for oath which you may have uttered without the thought but will take you to task only for what your heart has conceived and For Allah is the most forgiving and forbearing. Beautifully said. My brothers and sisters in Islam, you should know that it is our tongues that express the heart's desire. It's connected, completely connected. If a person is good, it will reflect on his speech. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it very easy for the tongue to move and speak. The tongue, if you know, the tongue is one of the organ of the bodies which moves more than any part of the bodies. Even if you're in the night, you might move it. Your tongue moves. And it's not difficult to realize that person's tongues move much more than anything else against us. So, if a person is not careful about what he says or she says, even a single word can nullify his action. One word come out of your mouth, they cannot take it back. It cannot be taken back. Can put us, this red tongue, put us in. Little thing put us in deep trouble. Therefore, my brothers and sisters in Islam, it is for that reason the whole body, taste the tongue, you know, tell the tongue, fear of Allah, and don't put us in trouble. Fear Allah and don't put us in trouble. Be upright. If you're upright, whole body, whole physical is upright. If your tongue say upright, tongue say right. If you say false, whole body turn. That tongue can take you whole body to heaven. This is tongue and heart. This is from Sunnah al-Tirmidhi. My brother and sister, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran al-Kareem, Surah al-Mu'minun, many times we mentioned, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ Allah subhanahu قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُؤْرَدُونَ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُؤْرَدُونَ Indeed, successful are the believers, those who are very humble with the prayer, خَاشِعُونَ And refrain from the vain talks, wrong talks. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala advises us. My brothers and sisters in Islam, here Allah mentioned refraining from the vain talks is a sign of successful believer. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ And it's talked about it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the successful, one of the things which can make a mu'min, a successful mu'min, holding you. And for those who take advice, take heed, there is constant reminder in the Holy Quran, Surah Al-Ghaf, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, not a word you say or is said, that there is a watcher by you ready to write. مَا يَلْفَذُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ أَتِيدٌ You know, right and left, angels. Anything you say, you write. Anything come out of, they write. SubhanAllah. Brothers and sisters in Islam, we should remember that at all times, the tongue, again, as can do wrong, is a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is one of the blessings, one of the miracle of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Excuse me. Miracle of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the tongue. Can you see the animal? Cannot talk. But we can with this tongue express. Praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and express what is in our heart. As mentioned before, of course, tongue has been designed for a zikrullah, nothing else's. For a zikrullah, everything we have to say here has to be from the zikrullah. Mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do it. Amal as-salah. Ibadallah. Rahimakumullah. In reference to the guarding your tongue from the old haram, Abu Musa al-Ash'ari said, of course, one asked, Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, So, Ya Rasulullah, which Muslim is our better? What character of Muslims? Which one is better? And the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, those who not harm the Muslims with their tongues and with their hands. That's from the Sahih al-Muslim. Ya Akhul al-Giram, the Messenger of Allah warned us and said, a Muslim is a brother of Muslim. He neither betrayed, deceive, or humiliate him, nor look down to him. Of course, I'm sure the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam meant all the people. He's not just a Muslim and we talk wrong to the non-Muslims. And because Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam subhanahu wa ta'ala ud'u ila sabil rabbika bil hikmat al mu'adhdhar hasana. If you see all the non-Muslim of the world, qayl al muslimin, if you see all the candidate to become Muslim, if you see your candidate, you know, atheist, job to you is it what the job the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was doing? Okay. You go follow the step of sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and talk to these people in the way which if the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was here, would have talked to them to bring him to Islam. You know, these are all being good candidates. Then we cannot just surah them. And many times happens. Many of the big people which we know, you know, you can hear in television, radio, they were against that person was against, totally against Islam, totally against the mosque, totally against Quran, banning the Quran, and in a few days he was Muslim. In a few days he was Muslim. Therefore, my brothers and sisters, you have to remember. Piety, and Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, it touches heart. Piety is here. While he was saying, while the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying, he pointed three times in his heart. He said, piety is here. Then don't do it. All praise is to Allah. Be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who prohibit harming the Muslim in all cases. And I said, in chapter 33, verse 58, وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْذُونَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ بِغَيْرِ مَا اكْتَسَبُوا فَقَدْ احْتَمَلُوا بُهْتَانًا وَإِثْمًا مُبِينًا وَإِثْمًا. And those who annoy believers, men and women, give them wrong names undeservedly, bear on themselves crime of slander and plain sin. Dear brothers, when we examine closely our Islamic laws, we find that they are most productive and most protective of the purity of the Muslim, in both figurative, physical, mental, spiritual, and by the sense of the word. They cover every type of moral impurity, even extending to acts of insulting people, cursing them, and calling them, and abusing names, wrong names. Unfortunately, my brothers and sisters in Islam, unfortunately, we see that many Muslims, especially, I said Muslim, not forget about the Muslims, when they talk, they talk one sentence, 20 F is in there. You understand what I'm saying? They think they get bigger. 20 curses in there. They do not understand. They curse each other. With this word, you're talking to each other. He's your friend. You're talking to him and bring that if you curse in him. And he's cursing you. What is wrong with they say, beautiful, may Allah bless you. Then they say, F this and F that and F this. You know, it comes. This is what has to be sorted out with the Muslims. Keep your tongue. Because if you say something wrong, you're cursing your brother. Or cursing yourself. Or cursing your body, as I said. لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيبٌ. They are here. They are watching here, recording. It's not joke, brothers. And it was, of course, from there, I explained it from that Tirmidhi. But brothers and sisters, this hadith indicate that. Slandering people, belittling them, Muslim or not, and cursing them are prohibited in Islam. A true believer is a decent person who uses the polite word and the polite phrases, and he will show the what the Islam is to the Muslim. As I said, we go and follow the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. No one seen the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam get even angry. One time he got angry for the one thing, but of course, no one seen the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam come one little word of wrong. Anything he said was a flower, and anything he said was a Quran. I never seen in the of course Sahih Bukhari and the six books which we have, Sahih Muslim and Abu Dawud and all. Anytime Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam being abused. Therefore, we have to remember that. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن الكريم ونفعني بإياكم بما فيه من الآيات وذكر الحكيم. أقول قول هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات، واستغفروه إنه هو الغفور. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونشكره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد الصادق صادق الوعد صادق الوعد الأمين وعلى إخوانه النبيين والمرسلين، ورضي الله عن أمهات المؤمنين وعن خلفاء الراشدين أبي بكر عمر عثمان وعلي رضي الله عنهم، وعن الأئمة المهتدين أبي حنيفة مالك الشافعي وأحمد رحمهم الله، وعن أولياء والصالحين. أما بعد، عباد الله، إني أوصيكم ونفسي باتقوا الله العلي العظيم، فاتقوه واعلموا إن الله أمركم بأمر عظيم، أمركم بالصلاة والسلام على النبي الكريم، فقال إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما، اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد، اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. فيقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن الكريم: يا أيها الناس، يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم، إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم، يوم ترونها تذهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت وتذا كل ذات حمل حملها وترى الناس سكارى وما هم سكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد. عذاب الله شديد. اللهم ربنا إنا دعوناك فاستجب لنا دعائنا. فاغفر اللهم لنا ذنوبنا واسرفنا في أمرنا. اللهم ربنا اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات، إنك قريب مجيب الدعوات يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا. اللهم ربنا أجلنا هداة المهتدين غير الضالين والمذلين. اللهم ربنا استر عوراتنا فامن روعاتنا واكفنا ما احمنا وغنى شر عذاب الدنيا والاخره يا ربنا برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين امين. عباد الله ان الله يامر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينحى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. أشكر الله العظيم يذكركم وأشكره على نعمته يزدكم، واستغفروه يغفر لكم، واتقوه يجعل لكم من أمركم مخرجا والله يعلم ما تصنعون. أقم الصلاة.